What's up, 502 crew? Welcome back to the channel. Ty, Ryan, Nick, back again with another reaction.
But first, if you like to join the 502 crew, we need to give this video a thumbs up.
And we need you to smack that subscribe button. Pow.
And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you never miss a video.
Like that? Like that smack. Yeah. Pow.
Okay, I can't hold off any longer.
Oh.
Time to get back to Rush.
It's been a while.
It has been a while.
We got back to a few people here recently.
Yeah.
And I just want to say, Rush is like, it's like a top 10 band for me.
Ooh.
Yeah. Now, the first time we did Rush, we did YYZ. Amazing song. Yes. Instrumental. Fantastic. One of the best instrumentals of all time. And, man, that was, what, the second week we started doing reactions?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was
our first video to 1,000.
Now, I have a couple things to say about that first video.
Ooh.
First off, our green screen was visible. Because at the time, we didn't have the lighting like we do now.
And also didn't have the equipment. We're on so much different equipment.
And we had on too much blue.
Yeah, we had on too much blue. I wore blue, you wore blue, and you wore a blue hat. So blue was the dominant color, which recognized that instead of the green.
But luckily, we don't have that problem anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Second thing I got to say, obviously the band members, we said Geddy Lee on bass, Alex Lifeson guitar, and Neil Peart. Yeah. On drums.
Which is the first time I've ever heard it said like that.
Yeah, now we were saying Neil Peart, and people were like, shut up! Stop saying Peart!
We didn't know.
Now, I think I heard that before, but I just kind of forgot. I think because I've seen so many interviews.
So many people say Peart.
Interviews of people talking about Rush and, videos.
They always say Peart.
Media. Yeah. A lot of them say Peart. And it's wrong. It's Neil Peart. So we have that down, you guys.
Which is going to take a while for me to get used to because Peart. I've always said Peart.
Yeah, it's Peart. So there you go. Don't say it anymore.
Here it is.
And the third thing, when we did that, Ryan had no idea how to react.
Yes, because it's a very different song.
Exactly. We basically threw you into the fire.
Yes.
On that one.
Yeah, thanks because a lot.
There were people commenting like, what's up with the dead guy?
Yeah, he's not interested. Even though you were interested, right?
Yeah. Very interesting because it was interesting. I never heard it.
Exactly. You never heard anything
I was
like
trying
that
to, I was trying to grasp it and get understand what is going on. So there was no head bobbing because I had no idea how to head bob to it.
Yeah. You were just.
Yeah, plus that song, it changes. The whole time, it changes.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's nuts. I mean, if you heard that song today, you'd be like, oh, this is fire.
Yeah.
But at the time, you're just like, I have no idea what this is.
Yeah.
Just wanted to
address some things, yeah.
Now, because that song didn't have any lyrics, I think we have to do Tom Sawyer, right? Now.
Which I said was my all-time favorite.
Yeah, and I know what you guys are saying, like, come on. Tom Sawyer, like, Rush has so many more good songs. Like, why are you choosing Tom Sawyer? This is strictly for Ryan.
Yes.
All right? I feel like this is just the song you have to start with lyrics. I
mean, it's like a bass line, like, this is Rush.
Right? I mean, this is probably their biggest radio hit.
Yeah.
You know, I could be wrong.
And it's only a favorite of mine, not because of the musical things or this or that. It's only for nostalgia.
Correct.
That's the only reason it's my favorite, because, you know, it brings me back to a time in my life.
So, let us do this song, get it out of the way.
It's my turn to
react. All songs by Rush are good anyway.
Correct. You really can't go wrong.
No.
Some facts about this song. Geddy Lee said the band hated this classic track when they first recorded it. He said, I remember being disappointed in the studio, thinking we really didn't capture the spirit of the song. We thought it was the worst on the record at the time.
Hmm.
But it all came together in the mix. Sometimes you don't have the objectivity to know when you're doing your best work. That's very true. And he also said they never foresaw the success of this song. He said, the one song that we had to play for the rest of our lives, when we wrote it, we had no idea that it would touch such a nerve with people. In many ways, it's the quintessential Rush song. See?
Very
true. There you go right there.
Very true.
And some other facts. This was in a clip on Family Guy.
I remember that.
Chester Cheetah.
Yes.
And it was also an episode of Futurama. So just like YYZ, this is from their album Moving Pictures, released in 1981. And, I mean, did I really have to say it? Tom Sawyer is the opener.
Once again, as always.
So, it's been too long, man. Let's go ahead and get this started. This is Rush, Tom Sawyer.
A Monday warrior meets Sawyer mean, mean pride.
Sound familiar yet?
I remember the like in the beginning.
You probably remember that from Family Guy.
Yeah, that's probably what it is. Okay. I remember that. I was like, oh, I heard that.
Okay. Yeah, okay. You heard that from Family Guy.
So, first time you've heard Daddy's voice.
This is way better than the other song, just so you know. To me.
To you. You like singing, though.
To me, yeah, exactly.
He likes singing.
His voice is nice.
This just started.
His voice is nice. It's already better because I know where I'm going.
That's what I was going to ask.
He is a different voice. Like, no one sounds like him.
Yeah.
It's more high-pitched, but I've never had a problem with Getty's voice because, one, I think it just matches their music perfectly.
What you
say? And he's always in key, though.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's the thing. So that's what I like about it. So.
It's just very different.
I noticed that dude has like 1,000 drums around him.
Yes, that's what he does.
Really?
He is...
It's because he's that good.
Yeah, he is the all-time drummer. He is certified GOAT.
And by the way... Obviously, we know they're Canadian. I assume this was filmed and recorded in Canada because you can see in the background they're in a forest and there's snow on the ground.
Yeah.
That's where I would like to record right there, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
No peace and quiet.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let us know, you know, where that was in Canada. So that's pretty cool. With the guitar right here.
Yeah. Fire.
The day's Tom Sawyer, he gets high on you. And the space he invades, he gets by on you.
Hey, and this is light for him.
Come on,
this
bro.
Is light work for him.
Oh my goodness!
Come on, bro.
He's seriously, he's the greatest,
dude. The not only him, but the talent in these three dudes is just off the charts. Is there a more talented trio? Please let me know.
Oh no!
Please let me know.
Nope.
I mean, that drum fill—that's one of the most famous drum fills.
Even whenever the guitar was doing his little solo, if you was listening in the background, then it'll boom, blah, boom, blah, boom.
Yeah.
That is not easy.
And during the guitar solo, the bass goes off.
Yeah, boom.
The bass goes off during the guitar solo. And like I said before, man, everybody talks about Neil and they talk about Getty. They should. They're amazing.
Yes.
But I'm telling you right now, Alex is just as good. He's just as good as both. I don't really think that I mean, obviously, Neil, he's one of the best drummers of all time.
He is the best.
But
get straight.
They're all, like, elite musicians.
Oh, yeah.
You know, there's good bands. There's great bands.
All-timers.
Then there's all-timers, elite bands. Rush is right here, man. Oh, sorry, yeah. I was like covering Ryan's face.
Yeah, yeah.
Rush is right in front of Ryan's face.
I was watching his hand. I was
it's
like,
an all-time band. But, yeah, I mean, what else can you say, man? They just, every time you listen to their music, it's like, my God, dude. Like,
oh, yeah.
So, so good.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm glad I paused it right here because I was going to try to get to this moment right here anyway. That is a movie poster. Eraserhead. That's an old horror movie, I believe. I could be wrong.
Is that an eraser on his head?
Ryan, me and you are big horror movie fans.
Yeah.
So I want to know, who's the fan? Is it one of the band members? Is it a producer? Let me know. And I actually haven't
That's
seen
it. That's a very specific movie. To put on the wall.
Well, that's
it's a famous movie.
Yeah,
I know
it,
that.
Is it a big deal?
Yeah, I haven't seen it though.
But, I haven't either. I've never heard of it.
Let us know who the horror fan is, if you guys know, and let us know if Eraserhead is good.
Yeah.
or is it overrated? You know, just give us your opinion on that too. But yeah, this is fire. What do you expect? And come on, I mean, I got to run that part back.
Oh yeah,
I mean, you just have to.
Could you be, like, listening outside?
Yeah.
She's like, what is going on in there?
Boy, I'll tell you what, man. That is fire.
Is certified platinum, baby.
And I love the ending shot of the woods right there, man. Yeah. That is a beautiful place. What else can you say, man? Rush. It's in the name. Rush.
Gives you a rush.
Yeah. Nothing else to say. These guys, come on. Come on.
All-timers, baby. Ryan.
Makes me speechless.
Let's hear you. Let's hear what you
I definitely like that song better than the other one, but that's just my opinion. I like the lyric. I like hearing somebody sing.
Yeah.
And he actually has a pretty good voice.
Yeah, he does.
Are they known for more instrumental than actual songs?
Well, they have...
they do both.
They have a good amount of instrumentals.
Really?
Yeah. I know that. Yeah.
So are they like known for their like what are they known for?
Just
are they known for the instrumentals?
Yeah,
or are they
being
known
an amazing band.
Yeah, well, I mean, exactly.
Everybody has an identity.
They're not, they're just like, they're really known for like their syncopations and like patterns and just different music style. The fact that they can change it up and stuff like that.
Rhythms.
Yeah, and rhythms and all that.
Time like signatures.
5/8 and all that
they're
stuff.
They're prog. It's prog.
Yeah, that's what they're known for, really.
Yeah.
Well, where he's playing the piano, it's like, I've heard that too.
Yeah, that's a big part of the
very
song.
Very famous.
Yeah, so I mean, I've heard that too. So yeah, I've heard a little bit of parts of it.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's a fantastic song.
This definitely gets your stamp.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You want to go ahead and just Ryan's stamp of approval.
That's right. Yeah,
that's right. And really, this is a song that there's really no weaknesses in it. I mean, what can you poke holes at in this song?
I would want this to be longer. That's how good it is.
I'm surprised I didn't like it. That's crazy to me.
Well, at first, anyway.
Maybe
they grew to liking it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure.
Ain't that crazy, though? You got to grow to like your own song that you made.
Yeah.
They've made a lot of songs.
If you make some, you're going to be like, oh, this is a masterpiece. And then it's like, oh, I actually don't even like it.
Well, you got to be real, man.
What?
You got to be real with yourself. But, you know, maybe they've grown to liking that song.
Yeah.
You know, like I said, it might be their biggest radio hit.
Mm-hmm.
So I would think that it holds a special place in their hearts. I know it does for you.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure they appreciate the income that is created.
Oh,
just
yeah.
the song.
Most definitely.
Amazing, man. I mean, I'm telling you right now, there's not going to be a song that we react to about this band that you're not going to like in some way, shape, or form.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're like just not. About it.
Yeah, like I said, they're up here.
Yeah, right on Ryan's dome.
Yeah, that's right.
So, give us some more Russ suggestions. And just remember, though, like we will do those epic instrumentals, but let's kind of work our way up.
Yeah.
You know, so
we got to hit the full spectrum.
Yeah, give us, like, we'll probably do like one or two more, you know, just kind of, they don't have to be radio hits, but just kind of like normal.
Yeah.
Normal-ish for Rush.
Yeah, normal. Yeah.
Type of songs, and then, like, we'll really hit the big ones. That is the end of the video, guys. Please tell us what you thought about that song. We love hearing your feedback. Please tell us your reviews.
Thanks for subscribing and hitting that bell.
Peace out.